It's those incredible animals and those incredible bears.
I turned and all I saw was black fur and teeth coming at me.
We'll see grizzlies wild and dangerous. Then we'll meet a man whose pet grizzly is just a big member of the family.
Don't touch that.
We'll find out where bears go in the winter. And then we'll join the Cub Club. Hello, I'm Loretta Swit, and welcome to Those Incredible Animals. They're big, they're strong, and in certain situations, they can be very dangerous. If you're in the neighborhood of this bear, you better not get between him and his dinner, because he's a grizzly.
A million acres of outdoor paradise, Glacier National Park, shared by the United States and Canada, and by more than 100 rare animals. Glacier means wilderness, getting so far away from it all that only a two-day hike will get you there. It's exhilarating, it's adventurous, but it's not carefree. Every step in Glacier is a step into the home of the largest, fiercest, most powerful animal in North America, Ursus horribilis, the grizzly bear.
I just turned and I heard a growl and a snarl, and I turned and all I saw was black fur and teeth coming at me.
And I got up the tree a ways and was hunching up, and she bit across my shoulder and pulled me out onto the ground again.
Unlike most creatures who would sooner back down and run from a human unless provoked, this bear attacks by its very nature, sometimes unprovoked. The grizzly is used to being king of the forest. A human can do little against this bear. A grizzly can weigh well over half a ton and stand 10 feet on its hind legs. It's fast enough to run down a racehorse in a sprint, and strong enough to rip the door off a car.
It's quite within the range of grizzly bears to kill human beings, and as long as you insist on packing human beings into grizzly country, it's going to happen over and over again.
Right here on this bank of the St. Mary River, two very experienced hikers set up camp for the night, Jane Ammerman and Kim Eberle. They had done everything right. They had not disturbed any bears. They didn't know there were any bears in the area. They did not keep any food in their camp. Still around 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, a grizzly invaded their camp, dragged both of them up and down the bank of the river, killed them, and in fact began to eat one of the campers. Kim Eberle's brother Bill was attacked by a grizzly bear in the same park just 1 year earlier, but Bill Eberle lived to hike again and tell about it.
And she all of a sudden started charging down, and there were only but a few really small trees in the area. We tried to climb up some. Some of the lower branches were dead, and they were really narrow trees. They didn't provide much support, so I tried to shuffle up away, but she bit into my thigh, and I could just, it was just kind of a pulling feel. It was pretty sharp. It wasn't a lot of pain, but she pulled me onto the ground and started nipping my back, similar to a dog bites, it felt like at the time, and then just sort of backed off.
Also lucky enough to talk about it is Roscoe Black, a man born and raised in the park.
And hit me and knocked me off the trail, chewed on my leg for a while, and then lay basically on top of me with its head right in this area. I could look directly into its eye.
J. Gordon Edward also stared a grizzly in the face. He hoisted his ice axe just in time for the bear to lunge onto it.
She took a tremendous jump, and the point of the ice axe went into her chest again. But she hit me so hard, I have a scar across here from this blunt edge of the ice axe hitting me. Knocked me uphill about maybe 5 feet so fast that my left hand flicked out, and she grabbed my hand in her mouth. So I dropped the ice axe, and I dropped right down my knees in front of her. And I was yanking on my hand, trying to get out of her mouth and talking to her, saying, come on, let go of my hand. I'm not going to hurt you. And I was patting her on the face or on the eyes. And she blinked those big eyes when you pat them. She closed her eyes, and she never bit down hard. It just held like a vise. It was numb. You know, up there, you hear about everybody playing dead. So naturally, I wanted to play dead. In one movement, my hand came out of her mouth, and I wheeled around, and I fell on my face in the other direction. Crossed my hands above my head so I could get the pressure point on my wrist and keep the blood down. Dropped on my face and didn't move.
Bill Eberle did not lie still and is convinced now that he should have.
And as she backed off, I made another run for a tree. And I think if I had stayed in place and not moved, that she might have left. But I think this kind of egged her on. And I got up the tree a ways and was hunching up, and she bit across my shoulder and pulled me out onto the ground again.
So if you give little or no resistance and basically play dead, which is a very difficult psychological thing to do. If you've got something chewing on you, it's very difficult not to raise your voice or become upset with the fact that you're going to lose an arm.
The best thing to do is avoid bears entirely. 90% of the time, the grizzly will hear or smell you and leave. To make sure, sing or shout on the trail. Wear bells. Women are warned against hiking during their menstrual periods. No one should wear colognes or even insect repellent. If you do meet a bear, stand still. Don't run, don't shout. If you have time, climb a tree. Adult grizzlies can't climb. If the bear charges anyway, the best thing you can do is play dead and hope for the best.
Yes, in certain circumstances, bears can be dangerous. But now let me introduce you to a woman who says they can also be cuddly. She's Gail Hedberg, a veterinary technician at the San Francisco Zoo. Gail, you raised a polar bear cub.
When Pika, which is here on our left, was first born, she needed to have a surrogate mother and had to be hand-raised. So when they are infants and they're small, they can be very cute and cuddly.
She
was born, she only weighed a pound. So you can imagine.
She's tiny.
She's very small, very helpless, and needed that intensive care for about the first 6 months, 6 to 8 months.
And when did you stop visiting her?
When she reached about 8 months of age, physically her size
outweighed you.
Definitely, definitely. But again, during the infancy, they need that special intensive care.
Yes. Does she still recognize you?
She does. When we come by in different zoo vehicles and the zoo is quiet, we don't have a lot of visitors, she then can focus and notice me. But I don't really promote that now because she does have a companion, Andy, and they seem to be very well adjusted.
Are you hoping they will breed?
We sure are. Polar bears don't become mature till they're about 7 to 8 years of age. So right now, she's just entering her prime.
Yes. Well, good luck.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, Gail. On those incredible animals. He's smart, he's big, he's cuddly. He's Bart the Grizzly.
He knows better than to bother people. I'm tired.
Coming up next, the world premiere episode of Wings of the Luftwaffe.
So Air Miles is gonna fly me free? How generous. What's the catch? So I get these miles on just about anything? Anything? I didn't see a car. So what's the catch? So what's the catch?
Which scoopable litter would the experts prefer? A leading litter or Scoop Fresh cat litter? They both clump. But does your litter freshen between scoops? Well, that proves it. Scoop Fresh freshens better between scoops.
1 year ago, our country fought to save a tiny nation. But we'd just like to remind you that there's another tiny nation worth fighting for. And this fight is far from over.
All new series. Rousing adventure. Intense drama. Amazing wildlife. Coming this fall on the Discovery Channel. A brand new season, bringing you the best of aviation, past and present, examining real-life drama, the triumphs and the tragedies, telling tales of nature, and exploring innovative technology. Be here for world premiere series and returning favorites this fall, only on the Discovery Channel.
Now that you've seen how dangerous grizzlies can be, I'm going to introduce you to a family that considers a grizzly just another member of the family. Well, a very big member of the family. His name is Bart.
Good boy. Up. Good boy. Walk, 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 walk.
He could easily kill this guy with one quick swat. But Bart the grizzly bear would sooner guzzle iced tea and play than eat up his friend Doug. Bart is a star, and he makes a ton of money doing movies and TV just by being himself. Bart lives with trainer Doug Seuss and his family here in Huber Valley, south of Salt Lake City. They share their lives with cougars, wolves, black bears, grizzlies, and others raised from infancy that comprise Wasatch Rocky Mountain wildlife, Doug's movie Animal Biz. To hear Doug's wife, Lynn, tell it, this all started
About 15 years ago, right after we were first married, and we didn't have any kids, and like a lot of young couples, he went out to get a dog for us to have, and he brought home a wolf instead. And it sounded good to me.
Eat those things up for me. Eat them up.
Doug. Get him out of my flower.
Oh, how he loves them.
After the wolves came some bear cubs Doug bought from zoos. And it wasn't long before the movie people found out.
People knew that we had particular bears, and we get a call, and a call leads to a call, essentially. So it snowballed.
Now, raising bears is a family affair.
Jack Cup.
Doug's two youngest kids, Sasha and Jedediah, pitch in to help with this black bear cub named Jack. But Mom isn't worried about the kids playing among the critters.
It doesn't bother me as far as safety for the children. They have rules, and they know, you know, where their bounds are. And I think we follow all the proper procedures, and all the animals are essentially bottle-raised and as tame as they possibly can be. And I just hope the children enjoy it.
Jack earns his keep by being cute in commercials. But getting Jack to act cute on cue takes preparation long before the day of filming.
If it's a car spot, we want that particular car available if it's something difficult, and we prepare that animal to work in and out of that car. You can't bring them coldly onto a set and expect safe and good performance.
Bart is the big star of this family. At 9 feet tall and 1,260 pounds, the Grizz can earn $2,000 a day on the set. But movie work with grizzlies is serious stuff.
Strike.
Bart's training began when he was 5 weeks old. Doug has taught Bart some 40 different commands.
White.
He'll pick up easy tricks in about 3 days, but he's still working on stay.
Stay! That's all right. You stay! You're fair.
All my training now is a mixture and primarily fun and games. There are specific behaviors that an animal must do for liability reasons, for safety procedures. They cannot be running around doing as they wish. They must not touch things that you don't want them to touch. It might be a $100,000 camera. It might be a person.
The training treats range from donuts to canned iced tea. Bart has the sweetest bear breath in the Rockies. Makes things a little easier on Doug.
You're a good boy. You are good. You're a good boy. Don't touch that.
An electrified wire keeps Bart in one area, though if he got angry, nothing could restrain him. Bart is trained, but not tame. And to keep an animal that could rip the doors off your car under control, Doug makes everything about training fun for Bart. Should the grizzly start getting grumpy, he'll put his chain back on and water him to cool him down. So far, Doug has a perfect safety record with his animals.
You see how safe an animal is? He's, he knows better than to bother people. I'm tired.
A new star isn't far behind. This little grizz is named Kobuk. He spent his first few weeks indoors, but growing bears belong outside.
He still much prefers that nice warm house and his food right there and his toy box in the corner. And he's just finding out that he's a grizzly, you know, and it's a shock to him.
Grizzlies are endangered in this country. Their numbers have dropped from 48,000 at the turn of the century to only 900 at present. But folks like Doug Seuss are showing us that grizzlies are not the monsters we sometimes think they are. They're huge, powerful, curious animals that deserve respect. They certainly have Doug.
Isn't he beautiful?
You can hardly believe that when Bart was only 5 weeks old, he weighed just 6 pounds. Just a little guy. And by the way, you might have seen Bart in some recent movies. A Disney film called White Fang and the critically acclaimed French film The Bear. A beautiful film.
Coming up on Those Incredible Animals, you have to be brave to go into a bear's cave.
You want to take that one home with you?
I think he's bigger than me.
Ready, Joy?
1993 Toyota Previa is for those families who always seem to have room for others. It could be because they have room for extra cargo. It could be because they have room for seven. Or it could be because in the Toyota Previa, there always seems to be room for one more.
So bright.
New Lemon Clorox 2.
So bright.
The brilliance of lemon in a liquid bleach.
Jackie's whites are whiter, but his blues are brighter. And Nikki is pretty as a rainbow.
Which scoopable litter would the experts prefer? A leading litter or Scoop Fresh cat litter? They both clump. But does your litter freshen between scoops? Well, that proves it. Scoop Fresh freshens better between scoops.
The Acts of Children. 16, 13, 12 years old. Kids Who Kill. On the next Justice File. Saturday at 10 Eastern only on the Discovery Channel.
Stop! Is there too much month at the end of the money for you? Perhaps bankruptcy is your answer. Call National Law Centers and stop bill collectors. Stop wage garnishments. Stop evictions. Stop the pressure and give yourself a new chance at a stress-free life. If you don't call, we can't help. Call National Law Centers and let there be money at the end of the month for you.
For your free personal consultation, call National Law Centers, 1-800-782-5111. Reasonable rates, reasonable terms, guaranteed results.
Radio stations? Well, if you like Manilow and the Carpenters, there's Coast and K-Big. And if you like rap and Top 40, there's Kiss and Power.
Now, there's a radio station for the rest of us. The new star, 98.7. Superstars of the 80s and 90s. Not a lot of soft, slow songs and not kid stuff over and over. Just great songs. The new star, 98.7. Superstars of the 80s and 90s. Finally, somebody got it right.
Bears go in the winter? Well, most of us have no idea, but when it's your job to know how many there are, how healthy they are, and where they live, you just have to go right to the bear in her cave.
High in the Laurel Mountains of western Pennsylvania, these men are on a hunting trip. Their mission is not to kill their prey, but to study it. They're on the trail of the black bear.
See those rocks just right up ahead of us there?
Yeah.
The big ones.
Pennsylvania Game Commissioner Dennis Jones and wildlife biologist Gary Ault are conducting important research on these huge creatures. Now, most of the time, Dennis and Gary stomp around these woods by themselves. But on this occasion, some of Gary's biology students from West Virginia University and some Game Commission friends are tagging along. The Game Commission doesn't use real guns on these hunts. They're tranquilizer guns. As a rule, black bears are not vicious, but these men don't want to take any chances, especially with cubs around.
All right, I'm good.
On this trip, Gary and Dennis will be checking up on two female bears. They've been tagged and wear a radio transmitter collar around their neck so that their movements can be traced. Most of the crowd is kept clear of the den, and everyone is quiet until Gary can get the mother tranquilized.
Did she budge when you hit her?
No. She just turned and looked at me, that's all. She's pretty lethargic, so.
Gary waits 10 minutes, just long enough for the tranquilizer to take effect, before he crawls into the den.
If I have a problem, I'll holler. Just pull my legs, all right?
Male or female?
Which is it, John? Male or female?
Male?
Yeah.
I think.
You're not sure.
Boy.
You want to take that one home with you?
I think he's thinking me.
These little guys were born 3 months ago, while their mother was already several months into hibernation. It's hard to believe that these 4-pound cubs will weigh 300 to 400 pounds when they're fully grown.
Get her stretched out.
Pennsylvania's black bears are the largest in North America because of a plentiful food supply.
172 pounds. It's pretty typical for a younger female. 172. In the spring, she would have lost about a third of her body weight since last fall.
Samples of the mother's milk and blood are taken for analysis. Scientists suspect that the blood may provide us with very important answers. Bears don't eat, drink, or eliminate waste for 6 months. They have an amazing ability to recycle part of their body waste during hibernation. This process could provide our astronauts with information on how to deal with suspended animation in space. And it may also hold a clue for helping burn victims speed their healing process. Finally, the mother bear gets a new radio transmitter. The cubs get weighed and tagged. Every step is taken to make sure that the bears are handled carefully and are disturbed as little as possible. A menthol ointment is put inside the mother's nose to hide the human scent. Then she's put back inside the den in a curled up position, just like when we found her, to keep her cubs warm.
It makes for a really warm abdomen when it's all rolled in a ball. And that's where you put the cubs, to keep them real warm, and then they'll start nursing and everything will be normal.
See you, little guy.
When it came time to leave, it was hard for some of us to give up these cute cubs. It was amazing that we'd been able to get this close to them. And equally amazing are the clues they could hold for our future.
On Those Incredible Animals, a little bear and his very special friend.
Coming up next, the world premiere episode of Wings of the Luftwaffe.
Sure, with air miles, I just buy the things I need, right? Like yesterday's newspapers. See, normally I buy beer and go to the movies. And call my mother. Love you, Mom. So what's the catch? I knew there was something. Hey, I'm going to Hawaii.
It's a beautiful day here at the Maple Street 500. Here comes the Previa. Here's the driver, Dan Chambers.
Who's the babe?
That's Mom. Look how Previa handles that curve.
Racking pinion steering, bud.
Passing the lead car. Tweet cam 16 valve power, dude. Way to go, Dad!
Guys.
Uh-oh. Gotta cut to a commercial.
I love what you do for me, Toyota.
So bright.
New Lemon Clorox 2.
So bright.
The brilliance of lemon in a liquid bleach.
Jackie's whites are whiter, but his blues are brighter. And Nikki is pretty as a rainbow.
Last time I stained my house with that other brand. This time, I'm using Thompson's stain.
Only Thompson's House and Deck Stain contains Thompson's Water Seal. It waterproofs better than even the leading brand's premium stain.
Now that's beautiful protection.
Thompson's Stain.
The acts of children. 16, 13, 12 years old. Kids who kill. On the next Justice File. Saturday at 10 Eastern, only on the Discovery Channel.
Lions and tigers and bears together at play? No, they're not your natural playmates. And it's not something you see in the wild. But at the Busch Gardens Zoo, they call it the Cub Club.
Summer vacation, a time when many kids get shipped off to summer camp. And these youngsters are no exception. Teddy, Sheena, and Shauna are spending their summer together at the Busch Garden Zoo as bunkmates. An unlikely trio, all right. A lion, a tiger, and a bear. But as far as they're concerned, they're just three happy campers.
They've gotten along very well. We don't know how long we're going to be able to keep them together because we've never done this before. Eventually, we'll have to take the bear away, probably more for her claws than her biting.
That's Teresa Walls, head counselor at this summer camp, and typical with camps everywhere, there's always that one counselor a camper really gets attached to. Yes, this is Teddy's first crush, summer romance at its peak. Funny, though, Teresa brushes it off as puppy love. Better look again, Teresa.
They love to play with you. The older they get, the more aggressive they get, and we can't play with them as much. Today, they're getting pretty wild. But when they're younger, they consider you their nurturer, and every time they see you, they think, too, and they start screaming for food. You're so ferocious.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Apparently, this is one camp where every day is visitor's day. Back in camp, it's time to chow down at the old mess tent. Unfortunately, it seems that when these campers went on vacation, their manners did as well.
You done? Little pig.
Go. It's mine.
Oh, come on, you ripped it.
As in most camps, water sports are extremely popular. Not to mention singing the camp song, rappelling, and taking courses in personal hygiene.
What's the matter? You taking a bath? You're dirty enough, you need one.
In fact, there are many outdoor activities to get tied up in. Are lions, tigers, and bears supposed to get along?
No, not at all. This is just something we're doing while they're children, while they're babies. So far, they're very affectionate, and they do cuddle quite a bit. They sleep together in a pile, heads sticking up and feet sticking out, and that type thing. They really do like each other a lot.
At 16 weeks of age, these baby bunkmates are spending their summer growing up together as sweet mates. And if you ever thought summer camp could be a real zoo, well, here it is. But one thing's for sure, this is one place you won't find any of those dog days of summer.
Thanks for being with us for Bear Watching, and we hope you enjoyed it. From the San Francisco Zoo, I'm Loretta Swit, and we'll see you next time on those incredible animals.
Loretta Swit's accommodations provided by the Campton Place Kempinski Hotel in San Francisco, part of a worldwide family of luxury hotels.
Coming up. Almost ousted from Hitler's Air Force, it persevered and later became a legend of the skies. The ME-109, next on the world premiere episode of Wings of the Luftwaffe. It's an all-new season coming this fall, only on the Discovery Channel.
Sure. With Air Miles, I just buy the things I need, like cha-cha lessons. Normally, my family eats. That's big. That's 4 miles. So what's the catch? Aha! Free.
Come face to face with a fearsome and